Combat feels super satisfying. Hi guys, PD here. Welcome to the channel. Welcome to another new video. Today we're playing Bears in Space, a brand new first person shooter game on Steam. Today we're going to be using a mod called UEVR by Praydog, and it's going to convert this flat game into a VR game that I can play in my headset. Full VR mode, we can play with the motion controllers. We've got 6 DOF. It feels just like a normal VR game. Now, lots of people have been asking me to make better guides. I can't really make any better guides. What you see in my video is my guide. So if you watch the first 10 minutes of my video, that's how easy it is for me to get these games working in VR. I don't miss anything out. All you need to do is follow what I do in the video. It's that simple. It really, really is. If there's any fiddling about or extra steps to do to get the game to work, I also show that in the video. So this is Bears in Space. It's working well apparently, according to the flat screen to VR Discord. I've not played the game yet. We're going to get this game working together. We're going to go through the whole process together. I'm playing the game with a Quest 3. I'm using Virtual Desktop Streamlook. And in the headset, I've got Virtual Desktop running, which is connected to my PC. I'm also using the Quest cable to connect to my PC. This also helps with recording. I'm going to head over to the flat screen to VR Discord to see if there's anybody talking about the game, to see if there's any profiles for the game. There might be some hints and tips on the forums that are going to benefit us when we want to play the game. So head over to the flat screen to VR modding community on Discord. You want to head over to the Unreal Engine VR section, scroll down, find the UE game section in here. I'm going to search for Bears in Space. Bears in Space, there we go. I found the game. Click on the picture. That's going to bring up a text box. This is where people are talking about the game. If I scroll to the top of the thread, scroll down, I'm looking for any hints and tips. There's a profile here for the game. It's a 6 DOF profile. He says it works really, really well and it feels like a proper VR game. So I'm going to download his profile. We're going to install the profile during the UEVR process. So it looks like people are having a good time. There's some other profiles popping up, but I'm going to use the top one for now. And now I'm going back to Steam. I'm going to run the game. This is my first time running the game. Unreal Engine. Bears in Space has been in production over the past 7 years by a core team of 3 developers. Okay, we're in the game. So the first thing I'm going to do is check the settings. Gameplay, controls, input, video. I'm going to turn everything right down for now, just so that I can make sure the game's running nice and smooth. I'll leave the resolution scale on high. Everything else can go to low for now. I can't see any advanced options here. So let me head back to the main menu. So now we're going to inject UEVR. If I go to my desktop, I'm going to run UEVR. If I was to use the AirLink cable directly connected to my Oculus software, then I would opt for the OpenVR when I play the game. Because I'm using Steam and Virtual Desktop, I'm opting for the OpenXR. In the drop-down box, we need to find the game. Bears in Space. Before I inject UEVR into the game, I'm going to load in that profile we downloaded. So if I go to import config, I'm going to add the profile now. Select it. The profile has now been added, so we can now inject UEVR. And you should see the screen change when it converts into VR. Just like that. That's it. That's all I've had to do, guys. That's my guide. It's that simple. If you want to tinker with the program, then I've got plenty of videos tinkering with the program. I normally set the standing height, set standing origin, and recenter view. I also tick this box here, virtual desktop fix. I still don't have a clue what this does. And I'm waiting for somebody in the community to tell me what virtual desktop fix does. But I'm in the game, look. You can see the game moving when I move my head. Okay, so let's jump into a new game. So we have a 2D cutscene. Okay, I'm in the world, and as you can see, everything's working. Look, I can use my controllers to move around. What's that? My radio is bouncing. And I'm using my left thumbstick to move. As you can see, this is like a natural VR game, look. I can look behind me. I can look down, I can look up. Now, if you see any stuttering in the game, the game's running really smooth in my headset. Any stuttering is me talking or moving the headset. But this experience so far in the headset, super smooth. These types of games you can play with the motion controllers, but sometimes you might need the D-pad. Now, to get the D-pad on the Quest 3 controllers, you have to hold your thumb over a hidden sensor. And when you hold your thumb over that sensor, the buttons become the D-pad. For simplicity, I like to use the gamepad to play these games. Okay, X to interact. Let's interact with the radio.
Lance Captain Admiral Atoms, you're required on the bridge at once. There's been a whoopsie.
There's been a whoopsie. Don't forget, this game is running on the low settings. And this is something you can't do when you play these flat games on a flat monitor. You can't look to your left, to your right, or behind you. You can only do this in VR. Okay, my turning's really sensitive. So I can see that cursor on my screen. Let me see if I can move it out of the way. The mouse cursor's gone now. Slippery floor. Okay, try to avoid the bananas. I do feel like I can turn the graphics up. So there's nothing down there. We might need to go this way. Into the med bay. X to interact. first aid kit. Somebody's flatlined. To the bridge. Okay, exploding barrels. Escape pod. Do we check the bridge? Warning, exposition prison ahead. Prepare for the bear scare.
Hey, that's the famous spacetronaut, Captain Maxwell Adams. He's just one mission away from retirement. After the events that unfolded on Klaxion Delta, where Max had to make the soul-destroying decision between the unimaginable and the unthinkable, High Command made the decision that his time was up and assigned him to this prison transport ship, the SS Ursine, as a final send-off. They believed he was past his prime and a long way from his gun-slinging, blaster-tossing, plasma-hurling younger self. But I expose to you, Trevor, if push comes to shove, and they teamed up into a stronger force of motion and wished to wage a battle against Max, well, even at his advanced age and with his traumatic past, I'd still bet on him, because the bookies are only paying negatives.
Okay, there's bears in here. Scary bears. With white eyes. Game saved. Why would you put a prison base right next to the bridge?
Rawr! Rawr!
Okay, so some scenes when the camera takes over, you've got no control. You can't look around. You're forced to look where the camera's looking. So we're on the bridge. Beware of the bear.
Hey Max, it's me, Theodore, and this is Paddington. Sorry to wake you from your afternoon nap. We've just been going over our whoopsie projections when we were interrupted by an unknown ship firing on us. And now it's become extremely important that we don't delay in considering the forecasts for our strategic blah blah blah.
Blah blah blah.
Blah blah blah.
Blah blah blah.
Blah 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 blah
blah blah blah blah blah
blah blah blah blah blah blah blah blah blah blah blah blah blah blah blah blah blah blah blah
blah blah blah.
Just give me the guns.
So what do you think, Max? Do you agree with our whoopsie prevention plan?
Oh bother! That was a big one.
This is General Cuddles of the Bearmonter Alliance. Your ship holds imprisoned citizens loyal to our cause. And one loose unit.
Rawr!
Release those bears in space immediately, or you will be destroyed.
We haven't had enough time to implement and test our whoopsie prevention strategy!
You have 10 minutes to comply. Preheat the laser beams.
We're a scientific prison ship! We have no weapons! We must jump to hyper quickness!
Pressing the button is usually my job, but I'm ever so scared.
We are doomed!
Rawr! Rawr!
Okay, safe but super boring. Okay, so let me select the dangerous button.
You woke up, sleepyhead. It's me, Bertana. But you can call me BT for short. Everyone else does. That dangerous hyperquickness jump we made plunged us deep into an unknown galaxy. And it merged our DNA together. Pretty neat, huh? We can chat about that later if you really want. But for now, we gotta get out of here. The ship is real beat up. Let's take that emergency exit and make our way to the escape pod.
So the HUD in my VR headset, the text and everything's right in the top right, so I'm really struggling to see the text. There should be an option in the UVR menu to be able to shrink the HUD, make it smaller, move it further away. I'm not too bothered about reading text anyway, I just want to play the game. There's honey in here, look, and a picture of a bear. The love of his life. Okay, into the escape pod. B to crouch. This looks really cool as well. These locations are really big. It's hard to explain how big they are. You can only appreciate the size of these locations if you've played a VR game. If you played the Star Wars Tales from the Galaxy's Edge, this looks as big as that spaceship at the start of the game. There's a shadow. Oh, it's a robot. Oh, it's Will Robinson.
What the heck is that? I'd kill it first if it was up to me. Get in close and attack it in the back. Like
I love robots.
Unsuspecting and defenseless. Yep, that's the bear code. Use the melee button to take it out, Maxie.
Do I have to? Oh, that's so cool to see my hands in 3D. Warning, warning, Will Robinson.
Back. Phew. Close one, Max. Let's make our way to the drop pods.
He could have helped me, though. Even the effects, like the smokes in 3D, I feel like I'm on this spaceship for real. That's how cool this is. Sorry, Will. Are we dropping down here? More robots.
There's more of them. Here, take my gun.
Thank you.
And quickly shoot them in the back before they notice we're here.
Okay, this is just working out of the box, guys.
It was either us or them, Maxie. Glad you followed the bear code. No time to waste. Looks like we're gonna have to fight our way through.
Okay, let me kill these bots and then we're going to try something with the Quest 3 controllers. Combat feels so cool. It does look like I've got a really small arm. It feels like I'm doing that. So this does not feel like a proper length. It feels like half an arm, but it's working, so I'm not going to complain. Have I got six stuff with these? I've got six stuff. Okay, so the profile's working, look. I can see an arm here though, that's a bit. Yeah, that's going to be, that's a bit weird. That's something that when you add six stuff to a flat game, to add like the ability to hold weapons, some games, because you've got like two hands, the other hand might get in the way. So let me try playing the game like this. If I keep my hand more or less here, that arm disappears. But this is working with the motion controllers. I've got full six stuff. And as you saw, I did not really have to do anything, any tweaking. I just installed a UEVR, I installed the profile, it's just working. This feels like a normal VR game. If you ever played High on Life with UEVR, that's what this feels like. Okay. This is working really well. Look at that. Yeah, the floating hand. So this is like a mesh. So in some games you might get a mesh that's just for the right hand. I've got a feeling this game's got the mesh for both hands and both arms. That's why we've got this appendage floating in front of us. But if you keep your arm like this, it's not going to be a problem. Down we go. Yeah, this feels so cool. It's super smooth, it looks really cool. Can I get to the button up there? We can. Okay, there's like a card here. Trading card. Nice. I do hope that these developers are watching me play this game, because their game in VR is fantastic. I want these developers to try their own game in VR. The only thing missing is there's no haptics. Well, that's something you can't expect playing a flat game in VR. So I don't really need my controller anymore. I can use the motion controls. Blow them up. It's working, look. I'm shooting where I aim. That door's locked.
Phew, we made it, Maxie. It got a bit hairy for a second, but I think we're in the clear now. Really, the nerve of those bots getting in our way. Should we try and rescue all those other bears in space prison? Nope, you're right, Max. They would want us not to save them. Okay, let's get out of here.
Max! Max! Wait for me!
Oh, you're alive. There's no room.
Blah, blah, blah.
Bye! Let's roll.
Okay, so am I a bear? I think I'm a bear, look. I've got bear hands. Very small bear hands. Level complete. Okay, on to the next level. Okay, I'm in some sort of shooting sequence, but I can't see the gameplay. I can't see what I'm doing. But you can skip the section, so when you die, look down, there's a menu, and then click the skip.
Maybe you should drive next time. All right, Maxie, take everything you think you know about bears and forget it. Max, let me tell you a little something about bears. Fact number 72, we don't take fall damage. Fact number 38, we can dash.
Okay, how do we dash? So the top Y button changes my weapons look. We've got like karate chop. The right trigger is your dash.
Fact number 15, we can double jump. Bear fact number 503, we can double jump and dash while in the air.
Okay, double jump, dash. Working. Nice.
Oh, look at that big building, Max. I reckon our way off this rock is gonna be that away. Bear fact number 5. Acid legs hurt you. Avoid them.
Okay, keep out the acid. Okay, Okay, who's this? It was Trevor's birthday.
Bend over. Maxwell Adams and Bear Tana, the man bear extraordinaire. Thanks for taking care of all the riffraff out front. And let me be the first to say, welcome to Zoltopia. Now I know what you're thinking. What's a handsome butt like me doing on a scrap hole mining planet like this? Well, let me tell you, I'm a butt of many talents. Most of those talents revolve around Vic Bucks. You see those crates over there? They're filled with Vic Bucks. Break them open as you come across them, then bring the riches inside to me, and I'll provide you with guns and ammo. But not just any lousy guns, no sorry, but upgradable guns! You know, guns that upgrade. I'm a little low on stock currently, still waiting for my shipment to come in. But for now, how about this scatter gun? It's on the house.
Okay. So we have a new weapon.
Upgrades the more you use it, so get out there and blast some bots.
We have a shotgun. Keep an eye on your current weapons upgrade. Okay, so when I'm playing the game with the motion controller, I can actually move the menu to read it better. Nice. Yeah, loads of fun. This feels quite powerful. We changed weapons, don't we? With the Y button up. Grab all that. Combat feels super satisfying. I'm out of bullets. If you hold down the X button, it does show you where to go. Oh, there's something in here as well, locked. Oh, that's locked. Is that a jump pad?
Yo, dudes! Need to chill out? I've got your save covered. If you ever see me kicking it, you know you can take five. But dudes, don't worry. Jason and Minty always has you covered. If you ever see that auto-saving icon on the bottom of the screen, you know your progress has been saved.
Okay.
Just remember to be gnarly and not turn off your game while it's saving. Otherwise, you could be in for a wipeout, dudes.
Okay, dude.
And that'd be totally bogus. Chill out, dudes. Your game has been saved.
Okay. Karate chop. Okay, we've got some bigger bots here. Off. There is actually a bit of auto aim as well. So the game is helping me. Nice. Grab the loot. I love how they explode as well. These guys are scared. Dang it. He's got a gun. We have robots with guns now. Karate chop. That was close. Gameplay is really satisfying. Nice. Grab the health. There's a new gun here.
Aha! The wagon killer caught red clawed in the act.
Nanny? Show yourself, ghost voice. Did you just hear someone speak? I swear I just heard someone speak.
Quit your tomfoolery. Your time has come, bandit.
Ah, it was you. That makes sense. Max, be a doll and kill them, would ya?
That's why you call a 10-gallon hat. Okay, it's like a machine gun.
You now have multiple weapons, Max. Hold the weapon select button to open the weapon wheel. Bears experience the flow of time at a tenth the speed a human does, so when you open the weapon wheel, I'll slow down time. You better believe that's bear fact number 21.
If you hold down the top button lock, you get a weapon wheel, it slows down time. Oh, who's that? So the little robot charging at me would be really scary in a horror game. Da-da-da-da. Really satisfying when you hear that clank sound and you hear the robot. Really enjoying the combat. No secrets here. Oh! Secret room. Nice. We have a new collector's card. Oh crap! Very similar to like Serious Sam. When you find a secret. Okay, there's health in here. That was cool. That's locked. Kill the party room.
Hey, Max, BT! Thanks for clearing out those old tenants. What do you think of my new location? You know, this part of the planet used to be a pretty docile mining outpost until you two showed up. You've got them all riled up. So I say shoot first and don't ever ask questions.
Oh, I agree. That's the bear code way, too.
Yep, better for business that way. Now, I got most of my shipment in, but I'm still missing an auto phaser that looks an awful lot like the one you've got right there.
Well, okay.
You better buy some ammo for it.
Okay, so scatter laser ammo capacity, we can upgrade now, look. I want to do the auto phaser though. It's going to cost me $2,000, I've got $4,000. That's now been upgraded. And we can buy some new armor. What's the question mark? Secret locator, £1,000. Cheers, mate. There's a secret nearby. How do I find the secret? Oh, it's here. What the hell? Okay, I don't know what to do here. It looks like I need an arm or something. Do I find an arm? Oh, hold on. Here we go. Found it. Oh shit. What is that? Okay, it's like a bonus game. So that one, he's the most deadliest. Very similar to Serious Sam games where you get the secret levels. Complete the oil ritual. I did it. Okay, onwards we go.
You know, Max, I've been keeping a journal of our adventures so far. Our gun upgrade progress, items we've found, secrets we should find, boys I like, you know, that sort of stuff. Open it up and check it out.
I don't know if this is going to work, though, with the motion controllers, because normally it brings up the meta menu. I've just got virtual desktop. I'm going to leave that alone.
I'm on a recon mission for the Carbogonauts. Don't tell anyone.
Okay, who was that guy? Karate chop! At least keep an eye on my health. Okay, we did it. Okay, do we go up here? That was behind me. Okay, what was this? Was that a secret or something? Oh crap, big guy. Okay, we've been down here, let me try down here first. Could be a secret. It's working really well with the controllers as well. Going down. Whee. Game saved. Pirate robot. I could play this all day. Superb. That reminds me as well, I really need to play that High on Life, because apparently it plays just the same as this game. Okay, is this the boss? Bring me the red one, and I'll let you through. He wants the red key. As you can see, I'm a little busy right now. Red key.
Gee whiz, Max, which key is it? They all look grey to me.
Try that one. Put it in the toilet.
Let's see if this is the right one.
This key is... I asked for crap. This'll teach you for wasting my time. Now try again. And this time, bring me the red key.
Okay, any clues on these? Let's go for the middle one.
Let's see if this is the right one.
That's not a red key. That's
fire engine.
Perhaps another listening point will help you figure this out. Alright, Earth Beast. Last chance to get this right. Now remember, Red Key.
Let's see if this is the right one.
Order, you bring me what I asked for, but you've wasted me day, and this time, you're really done for.
Well, we got the right key anyway. Who's that? like a boss. Take that.
Oh, well, I hope next time you'll take color theory more seriously.
That is the last time we're dealing with colored keys.
Open sesame. ...100% a UEVR recommendation, this game. Okay, bad guy up there, let me get my pistol. Got him. Where is he? Take it. Is he supposed to be like a Rambo character? What's that? Secret nearby.
Hey, welcome to Trevor's birthday, Pam!
Surprise! Hey, wait, you're not Trevor! This will be the last party you crash!
Okay, it's my party now.
Birthday again. Those jerks. Gonna be another lonely birthday for Trevor.
With Trevor. Is he friendly? Sorry, Trevor. Oh, look at this. Collectible. Yes, happy birthday, Trevor.
Come on in for all your spending needs.
Okay, we've got like a carp gun. So it's like a bubble gun. Anvil launcher. Wow. Okay, I'm going to upgrade my auto phaser. Let's go back. Can we buy one of these? What's this? Tri-shooter. I don't have enough money. Okay, repair all my health. Grab the armor. That'll do. Down we go. Alarm. Kill everything. Nice. Okay guys, well I'm going to leave it there. Thank you for watching, hope you enjoyed the video. Please leave a like and subscribe. Be sure to hit my little bell. I will see you in the next one. Bye.